In this experiment, we will see how light behaves when it is reflected off a convex mirror. A spherical mirror is a mirror that has a curved surface. It can be considered as a part of a larger reflective sphere that has been cut open. The concave mirror can be considered the part of a spherical mirror whose internal surface is the reflective surface. A convex mirror can be considered a part of a spherical mirror whose external surface is the reflective surface. Spherical mirrors reflect light falling on them differently from a flat mirror, and hence the images they produce are also different in nature. A light ray traveling parallel to the principal axis of a convex mirror will reflect off the mirror as though it is originating from its focus point F, shown by the dotted lines. And a light ray traveling towards the center of curvature of a convex mirror, point C, will reflect off the mirror along the same path that it was traveling in. In other words, it will retrace its path. Let us consider two light rays. First ray, the blue line, traveling through the top of an object and parallel to the principal axis of the convex mirror, will reflect off the mirror as though it is originating from the focus point F. A second ray, the orange line, also traveling through the top of the object but towards the mirror's center of curvature C, will get reflected and retrace its original path itself. Where these two rays meet will decide the nature of the image formed by the mirror, such as size, smaller or larger, direction, erect or inverted, location with respect to the point C, C dash, F, F dash, and type, real or virtual. Note, objects in this experiment do not imply only incandescent objects. All observations made here hold good even for objects that are reflecting light from other sources. An incandescent object like candle has been used as the object in this experiment so that its image can be captured on an external screen. The light rays emerging from or getting reflected off an object travel in all directions. Also, rays could emerge from all parts of an object as shown below. However, we will only be considering the rays reflecting off the mirror for the purpose of our study. As only the two light rays traveling from the object mentioned earlier, one traveling parallel to the principal axis and the other traveling towards the point C, the center of curvature of the mirror, decide the nature of the image formed, only these two rays will be considered in our study. For clarity of pictorial representation, in the ray diagrams, we have shown the path of the two light rays emerging only from the top of the object instead of the entire object. The two rays are the one traveling parallel to the principal axis, shown by a blue line, and the other traveling towards the point C, shown by the orange line. By understanding the path taken by these two rays, we can understand the type of image the mirror forms and how they differ with the position of the object with respect to the mirror. To understand the image formed by the mirror, we will place the object at varying distances from the mirror and identify the nature of the image formed and draw the corresponding ray diagrams. For this, we will need a convex mirror. The mirror we are using has a focal length of 10 centimeters. The focal length of the mirror is given on the packaging or the cover. A candle and lighter or matches. A lens stand or piece of thermocol to hold the mirror, a white sheet of paper to act as the screen, and a measuring tape. If a measuring tape is not available, draw a line on a large sheet of paper using a pencil or pen, or on the floor using a chalk and ruler. On the tape, mark points C dash, F dash, and P as shown. The distance between points C dash and F dash and points F dash and P is equal to the focal length of the mirror you are using. In our case, we have marked the points C dash, F dash, and P 10 centimeters apart from each other. Place the mirror at point P and place the candle beyond the point C dash. Move the white sheet of paper that is acting as our screen from point P, where the mirror is kept, towards the point C dash. And beyond if necessary, till a clear image of the candle flame is formed on the screen. You will notice there is no clear image formed on the screen. But if you look into the mirror, an image of the candle is visible in the mirror. When the object is placed at a point beyond C dash, the ray from the object traveling parallel to the principal axis, the blue line, gets reflected as though it is traveling from the point F, the focus. And the ray from the object also traveling through the top of the object, but towards the mirror's center of curvature, the orange line, gets reflected and retraces its original path. The blue and the orange line, after getting reflected off the mirror, travel away from each other and do not meet. Hence, no real image is formed. However, if these rays are extended backwards as shown by the dotted lines in the ray diagram, they will meet to form an image inside the mirror. The image formed is smaller than the actual size of the object, erect and virtual in nature. Now, move the candle to the point C dash. Move the white sheet of paper that is acting as our screen from point P, where the mirror is kept, towards point C dash and beyond till a clear image of the candle flame is formed on the screen. You will notice again there is no clear image formed on the screen. But if you look into the mirror, an image of the candle is visible in it. This is because, again, the blue and the orange line, after getting reflected off the mirror, travel away from each other and do not meet. Hence, no real image is formed. However, if these rays are extended backwards as shown by the dotted lines in the ray diagram, the rays will meet to form an image inside the mirror. The image formed is smaller than the actual size of the object, erect and virtual in nature. When the candle is placed between points C dash and F dash, no image is formed on the screen. But an image is formed inside the mirror. This is because, again, the blue and orange lines, after getting reflected off the mirror, travel away from each other and do not meet. Hence, no real image is formed. The rays, when extended backwards, form an image in the mirror which is smaller than the actual size of the object, erect and virtual in nature. Similarly, when the candle is kept at point F dash, an image of the candle is visible in the mirror. This is again because the blue and orange lines, after getting reflected, travelled away from each other and did not meet. No real image was formed. However, a virtual image was formed in the mirror which was smaller than the actual size of the object, erect and virtual in nature. Lastly, place the candle between the point F dash and the mirror, the point P. Again, you will see an image of the candle in the mirror. Even at this position of the candle, the blue and the orange lines, after getting reflected off the convex mirror, travel away from each other and do not meet. Hence, no real image is formed. The rays extended backwards meet to form an image in the mirror, which is smaller than the actual size of the object, erect and virtual in nature. Hence, we can say that irrespective of the position of the object with respect to the convex mirror, the image formed is always smaller, erect and virtual in nature.